Chilltown JC's been doing it since the beginning of time.
It's the party, come on, everybody.
Got ready to burn. Rock to the beat, y'all, the rock and roll. The rock and roll to the beat, to the break, has jumped. The thermal turn, all for wheels of steel. Cutting up, he knows the real deal. Rock to the beat, go to rock it on. Rock to the beat, to the break of dawn. To the beat, beat, you can't speak. Young ladies, let me hear your heartbeat. When your heart beats once and then it beats twice. You know I'm on and you know I'm nice. Cause I'm on, I'm bad, I'm so bad. About to catch a female with the wake of my eye. I turn brass, there's a goat and go in the brass. Let's see, make the girls want to wiggle the ass.
I want to wiggle the ass, want to rock the beat. I want to groove to the wheel of rubber rockin' so sweet. Well, my name is Master C and I'm ready to go. So I'll be when you're rockin', let's rock at the show.
Do it, come on. Fly girls so sweet, fly girls so on. I catch them out there in the on the bomb, the on the bar. I rock it on, and on the bar. I rock it on, and
Messi rocks it on, and I'm guaranteed to rock, drop, get on, y'all. With Thermotep is the man, all the one and two. We're just rocking the beat with the serious fly crew, and these are down below. Rock, rock in the house. Most females think I wanna turn it out, but I'ma tell you like this, don't get me wrong. Don't get on the mic if you don't belong. So you listen to my name, and then you listen to me, rap, cause I'm a bad motherfucker, keep it under the cap. So listen out, y'all,
listen.
And don't shout,
listen
y'all.
Up.
So listen out.
Coming to you live from Chilltown JC. Chilltown JC, man, it's like the extra borough to the 5 over in NY. You know what I mean? When you talk about hip-hop, Chilltown was doing it. I'm talking about early 80s. Matter of fact, I still got flyers with Sweet Slick and Sly, Treacherous 3, Cold Crush Brothers downtown at the Armory Building, for real. I recall when I was like in 9th grade, we used to catch the train from Newark out here just to come to parties and things of that nature, because unfortunately, where I'm from, out there in Newark, they got up on hip-hop a little later. Chilltown was always doing it, man, for real. And years later, I had the privilege to link up with Miss Champagne, my man Chill Rob, my man Apache Lottie, and the rest of the Chilltown family, and they embraced me, and I'm grateful to this day. And this is the God Lakim, and I'm here to say, recognize the real. Chilltown JC will forever be real when it comes to this thing called hip.
Tigerhood, baby, fat boy, new era, you know what I mean? Tell you about that old era though, you know what I mean?
Yeah, this is Master C live from the Lincoln High School, the place where it all began back in the days, the old gym. Yeah, we used to do it up big. And when I wasn't emceeing, and I was sneaking in the back through the window, you know, with the 40s of old gold. With the quartz of old gold, because 40s wasn't out then, you know. And the bottles are marked up. You know, we was doing it up real big, you know. But inside that place in the gym, you know, I was doing it real big, you know, with the Fabulous Five, me and my man, AKA Knockout Man, you know, Brad Thomas, you know. My DJ, Count Basil, he was the master mixer, you know, of the break beats. You know, he didn't scratch and cut and none of that, but he was a smooth operator, you know, doing his thing.
Hey, what made you get into music?
Well, what initially gave me the spark, the DJ, was coming up with DJs like DJ Grand Wizard Capone, DJ Earl Jones, Mickey Bonds, Dwayne Brookins, Teddy H. So during that time, hip-hop was in its infancy stage. The crew that I was part of was called the JCB Chiba Crew.
I'm so to the bone. Yes, y'all. To the beat, y'all. you know, I'm unique, y'all. Think ya, rock the house.
Come on.
Quick, quick, rock the house.
R.I.P. Rock the house.
R.I.P.
Rock the house.
R.I.P. Rock the house. Keep us cool.
Rock the house.
Chiba Crew was consisted of myself, DJ 33rd, MC Brooklyn D, and MC Mellow J. And for a short period of time, we had yours truly, Champagne. After that, we had a female MC, her name is Lena Lee, and she was part of the Chiba Crew. Also, for a short period of time, we had MC Whoopa Redski. He was part of the Chief Club at one point. And then on the side, we had DJs like DJ Derek D, who now lives overseas. You know, pretty much is the Chiba Crew, the entertainment part of the Chiba Crew.
Education. That's kind of when I first started playing movie. I was in a group called Phase 3. It was me, Miko, and Kaz. And later, you know, as things progressed, we got down line, we formed this crew called the Tranquilizer 3, which consists of me, DJ Razel, Cash Money, Mellow C, and Shazeen, and myself. Now we formulated a crew called the Tranquilizer 3. As we went along in life, we doing shows and things. There we got one record deal with Jerry Bloodrock. Mm-hmm. And like I said back then, you know, record deals wasn't really no good record deals. It's you just made a record and you never really saw no proceeds at that time. So everybody was just doing everything for free. Mm-hmm. But that's how we got started.
Now, what year was that? Did you formulate the group?
Oh boy, well I started like 79. We probably formulated the group, the Train, probably like in 81, 82.
Education.
Now back then, like I said, a lot of us didn't really get no respect. We had to earn it.
Right.
We had to earn a lot of respect. Like, you know what I mean? If your crew, it was only really, really two crews I know in Jersey City that was actually good enough to hang out with the crews in New York. And that was the Sweet Slick and Slide crew and the Tranquilizer 3. Those are two crews that I knew, you know what I'm saying, that actually hung up. I give Killer Cross some credit too, but they, you know what I mean, they was there, but they never really spread out like they should have.
Here's a Killer Force MC, the best in Chilltown JC. So let us put it to perfection while we change it to the Killer Force connection. Other crews in affection always try to vamp the connection.
In 81, Victor Quick, you know, he was one of the Sweet Slick and Slide first DJs. Victor Quick was real fast, you know. He was a legend, you know. He was real fast. And I don't know if y'all know, but Killer Force, they had Tony Tone. I don't know, boy. Tony Tone was one of the best boys on. I don't think, no disrespect, but I don't think anybody could touch Tony Tone. The way he used to rock them turntables, I was like, wow, man, this cat got skills, you know. Him and DJ Thurn, and don't forget Capone, man. Capone was nasty on the set. They all was nasty, you know. I can tell you this, it wasn't none that wasn't good. You know, and they, if it was a battle, yo, it was hard to decide who was gonna be the winner. you know? Started in Chiba Crew in the year 81, you know? It originated off of Boxwood Avenue, you know? And all the crews, you know, all my boys, you know, we had two parts of the crew. You know, we had a part, you know, that did their things on the streets, you know, and then we had the rapping part.
All the Chilltown JC hip hop legends, Chilltown JC hip hop legends, Chilltown JC hip hop legends.
Yeah, I'm born on 125th Street in Harlem, Grant Projects, you know, Phyllis Ford, Dougie Fresh, all us, you know, Fantastic Three and all that, you know, Cold Crush and all that. Moving over to Jersey City, you know, I ran into my family, you know, Sweet Slick and Sly, you know, Lord Albi with the family. That's my brother, rest in peace. Jimmy Mack, Warren Prince Bad, Stranger D, Cool Ray, Victor Quick. And our little nephew right here was, you know, baby boy coming up real young. But he learned a lot from us. You know, we was running the 80s and the 90s.
Try to bite my name. I turn around and put them all through shame.
Life became, you know, different after we all chose the path that we chose, which led us away from the music, and the music was the foundation to keep us together. We was winning all the battles over here, running Jersey City. But we battled some of the crews like the Tranquilizing Three from Duncan Projects, the Four Fly Guys from Montgomery, Classical Four from Marion, the Killer Force from Midtown, basically DSI and anybody else who got in the way. They got left by Sweet Slick and Sly, you know how we do. You know, never ran, never will, we live on the hill.
Crew.
Sweet Slick and Sly crew. They had a couple of cats. You know, Albie, he was a pretty boy. He was an alright rapper. But the best rapper they had was probably Warm Daddy. And I like Jimmy Mack. But Jimmy Mack was comical and he also brought a different edge to it with a little singing. It wasn't just playing rapping all the time. He wasn't always trying to be hard. You know, I like the harmonizes they used to do. And Sweet Slick and Sly was alright. And by the way, we battled them at the place to be. Of course, we won.
Came as like the last member because they already had their little foundation. And more or less, we just took off from there, winning all battles, you know. We come and get on your set, you know, when we leave, the crowd leaving with us. And more or less, that's how we did it. Like, you know, everywhere we went, we took the show from here to Hackensack, to Patterson, the North, the East Orange, the Brooklyn, Bronx, Queens, Long Island, Staten Island, Force MCs, you name it. We've been there and done that. We even took it down South Jersey, Atlantic City, Trent, wherever we went, Philly. We always got busy, feel me?
Feel you.
Yeah, man, I was basically... I was born in it. I was born Sweet Slick and Sly from day one. Like,
uh-huh.
A lot of people that don't know, you know what I'm saying? Like, I was rapping first before, you know what I mean? I blew up off the DJ and the mixtapes and parties and all that, you know what I'm saying? You already know my Uncle Albie Al, you know, everybody thinking my pops, you know what I'm saying? Because he always had me with him. I was the breakdancer on stage 4 or 5 years old at all the shows, at the skates and all that, you already know. I just came from that. I came from Triple S, man. It was what it was, man. You already know. Lord's son all day. Doing a lot of things. Like right now, I'm DJing, producing, promotions, rocking the parties. I'm getting into the acting now, you know what I'm saying? Got some things in the work. I don't really want to expose it yet, but y'all see it real soon. It's going to be on. You know, urban modeling, of course, that too. Just, you know, keeping it sucker free, man. You know what I mean? No new friends. You know what I mean? As you can see, Hump right here. You know what I mean? Everybody that started it for me, that's who I deal with. You know what I mean? Like, they paved the way for me, so now I'm the new era. I come from the old school. I was raised in the old school at a real young age as a baby. Mm-hmm. So you already know, like, it was embedded. You know what I mean? It's only right that I continue the legacy of what my Uncle Albie Al left out here. And there ain't too many of the original Sweet Slick and Sly brothers out here left. So those that are still out here, I try to get with them and do different things, you know what I mean? Get in the studio with them, kick it with them, have them come out, rock out with me at some of my shows and parties or whatever. and just, you know, keeping music, man, because that's my life. That's what I do. This music shit is my 9-to-5.
Let's deal with reality. It's time for us to save our young families from struggling. I don't have to sell drugs by hustling negative, because now I'm taking positive steps. Like Dr. King and Malcolm X, I got a lot of respect. I teach unity that's born inside the black community, so we can all get a job and have a real opportunity to teach the youth about our ancestral roots as we digest herbs and fruits, calling out black soldiers and troops. Let's salute those that's dead and gone, Lord, I'll be out, rest in peace in that white coop, and all my peoples that's still trapped down Trenton and Rory State Prison that's in the lifers group. Is you feeling me? All this time, was you just kidding me? We could talk about freedom, dreams, military things, and revolutionary things, and girls that the young boys call bitches, but I call my sisters black queens. And just because you was down prison and you came home with your weight up, when you got home, you was getting high chasing crack fiends. But now it seems that somewhere your lines was crossed. Somehow, the understanding was lost. Or somewhere you missed it. Your dialogue must have got twisted.
What's going on in Chilltown, JC? Well, in regards to music.
Respect, dear, as far as what we did and how ever. You know, basically the South wasn't getting no run back then, but now they get all the play, you know what I mean? Uh-huh. And more or less, like, harmonizing and all that stuff, we was doing that in the 80s, you know what I mean? More or less, it's like they come out with a hit, you know, just bought a Cadillac, put some D's on it, you know, I ain't talking about nothing. That's like Montana might be the only one getting a lot of airplay up this way, you know, as far as like swinging that down South, like chant. You know what I mean? But most things, everything that turned to chance or whatever hook you got, you know, if it's hot, Rick Ross, whoever's spitting it, you know, we look and learn from guys like D-Block and them, you know, they might be the hardest out, but I want to be the one with the most money.
Uh-huh.
You know what I mean? So on the strength, man, it's no disrespect to them brothers for keeping it how they keep it. And we had to learn the hard way, like, you know, you got to make things for radio play. You know, a lot of people get scared when you start talking about reality and what's going on in the hood where you live at. So basically, you know, we don't want to be sugar-coated. We want to keep it real, but we also want you to come there and feel relaxed. You know, when you're there, you know, you definitely protected. You know what I mean? We got that respect where we carry ourselves, and those that's around us going to respect us. You know what I mean?
I'm going to do this one here in honor to the music. Hip-hop, jazz, merengue, it's all music. You can give me rock and I roll with it. The music got me going out of control, man. I do this for the love of the kicks and snares, bass drops and all. I can't get it popping with y'all. I need a soul clap, feet tap. You where the beats at? And all my real hip-hoppers in the streets at is making room for more coming entrepreneurs. I need a scratch in the back like it's yours. The Run DMCs, the Tali Qualis, it's most definite common that these real MCs. I'm so old school that I've probably been left back. 80s baby, so I'm a product of that crack. No Goldie, but roll with that Mac. Beat the streets up and kick when it clap. I'm not falling off, won't get comfortable. You hanging on a cliff like your name Claire Huxtable. It's a cold world, but it's warm when they loving you. It'll make you shiver, my nigga, when they don't mess with you. So I bang on cats like Blake Griffin. Bring it back, you Ewan and I'm Pippin. No work, no wheels, how is you whipping? Truth be told, I dared to be different. Strapped in, ready to ride. You wouldn't fight a stain if your last name was Ty.
I'm a DJ, so I used to do all the parties, bring all the equipment outside, do all the block parties. So a kid named from the streets like a stock named Charles Gore, called Chee Chugga Luck. He was familiar with New York. So he actually brought like Biz and Doug and them over here. And then as they came over, you know, me, Biz, Doug, and all of us got fly. We really got affiliated and got cool with them.
Okay.
Yeah, I got a lot of linkage into Jersey City, and it started way back from like 85, 84. I mean, I remember when Joey Tom, I met them, actually. I don't know if I should say this, but I got to keep it 100. I met Joey Tom and Chuck and the rest of those cats at Broadway International. I think I might even had a show that night. And while I was supposed to be preparing to do a show, there was a dice game going on in the bathroom. Anybody that know me from back then, you know, I pretty much made a living just as much as, you know, performing as I did shooting CeeLo. And them cats realized who I was. It's like, that's LA Sunshine, but he had a dice game, and they had an established, they established a level of respect for me just for, you know, being able to be that gully
but at the same time, you know, be the person who I was. For them to have looked up to me from a hip-hop perspective as an artist, a recording artist, as an MC, and at the same time to be able to flip that script and be like, nah, you know, what's the bang? We established an immediate rapport. That's how I met them cats, and we've been like this ever since. We've had an established rapport and a relationship with groups from Jersey City for as long as I mentioned. Groups like Tranquilizing 3, Sweet Slick and Sly, you know, the Chief Chucks and the Al Bials and of the world, the Stranger D's, all of them cats, for one, their level of respect for what hip hop represented was real. It was real, real. Like, but they also were holding their own. Like, when we got out to Jersey City, I forget the date and time, I mean the date and place when we performed, but when we got out there and we performed and those cats, like, got a, they were part of the show, quite honestly, they were holding it down. You know, and I was impressed by their level of hip-hop acumen. They took it seriously, like I said, and they was putting it down. They had Jersey City on smash between them and Trank. And they were doing their little routines and stuff. I'm like, okay, nah, these cats is, you know, they putting it together. And they had their own individualism. Like, you know, you, from Al to Chuck to Shabazz, all of the cats individually had their own mark. But they also was laying it down on a lyrical tip, and they had their little routines. They was kind of hot. I mean, I appreciated them for what they brought to the table as well as the Tranquilizer 3 with Joey Timeless, Shazam, and himself. Again, you know, and the through line that I'm realizing is Joey Time and the Tranquilizing 3, the relationship along with Sweet Slick and Sly that they've established with all of the artists from New York back in that time, like the Dougie Freshes, the Biz Markies, JDL, Mike C from the Fearless Four, people like that. We used to frequent Jersey. I mean, not to the extent that I did. Like I said, I've lived there, but all those cats was regular mainstays, and not just from the parting setting. Like, we go, you can, any day, you can just go and find Doug just sitting down at Duncan Projects and chilling.
We get straight from the max. We get that paper, because I'm a chase and get that. I ain't worrying about what they talking about on that plaque, because we got jail on the street, and it's a fact. They snatching the place, they snatching your wits, they snatching everything, even your girls is coming off quick.
Give it up for the truth. School DJs, from the old to the new school DJs, rock the party, make it look so easy. Where would we be if it wasn't for the DJs? Give it up for the true school DJs, from the old to the new school DJs, rock the party, make it look so easy. Where would we be if it wasn't for the DJs?
Craig NRCE, I'm Nitro and I'm hyped, so peace and blessings to my brother Sweet Slick and Sly. Stranger D, you know how we used to do it in the basement 3 years ago.
Peace. Sweet Slick and Sly crew, Al Bial, rest in peace. Cool Ray, DJ BK, there's a lot of them out here. Flash, Wimpy B, you know, we all go back, and, you know, just want to say, you know, I love hip hop.
My favorite DJ personally from Jersey City, back in the day, Wimpy B. I didn't know Joe Smith then, but later on I know about Joe Smith. Years passed. Joe Smith and Wimpy B, Jersey City, yo.
My favorite DJ is Wimpy B.
Who's your favorite DJ in Chilltown, JC?
You know it is, Nicky Barnes. Okay. Nobody but Nicky Barnes, Fulton Park, in the 80s, 90s, 80s, and so on and so forth.
DJ Wimpy B.
My favorite DJ is Wimpy B.
My name Cool. My favorite DJ, I have two. Wimpy B and Nelly Nell, man. You know,
Wimpy B
did his thing when I was a kid. Nelly Nell did his thing when I was a teenager.
I like 007, Nelly Nell, Mad Money, and I'm from Kevin Wood.
My name is Marquita, better known as MC Key to Key, formerly of Main Attraction, signed to Fearless Four, OC Crazy Eddie. We did a couple of records. I'm originally from the Bronx, but my family lives in Jersey City. I came to Chilltown, and I used to spend my weekends here. And because I was from the Bronx, I was fascinated because there was so much talent here. First DJ I ever saw in Jersey City was DJ Nicky Barnes. He DJed right here on the porch. He was getting it in. I fell in love. Second DJ I ever saw, I went to Lincoln High School to a party, and Basil put Wimpy B on, and that was it for me. I saw Wimpy B, and I just fell in love.
Yo, I'm the legendary DJ Wimpy B. Y'all know who it is. Chilltown's finest.
Some of the places that you DJed at in Chilltown, JC.
I DJed almost every venue in Jersey City.
Give me some names.
11 School, St. Pat's, Sacred Heart, Shelton Post, The Bindery, Salem, Lafayette. I played all of the churches, St. Pat's. I might have mentioned that already. My staple was 11 School, Foxes. I got a lot of them. I'm about to get too many to mention. I can remember at this time, though.
Well, what started you to DJ? What gave you that crave, and how did you get started?
I started, somebody told me I couldn't do it.
And who's that somebody?
My cousin.
And who's your cousin?
My cousin DJ Slick in North Carolina.
Okay, so you out-slicked him, right?
Yeah, I out-slicked him. He was in Brooklyn at the time, but he told me, he said, you can't do this, you can't do that. And I proved him wrong. And that was back in the days when I started DJing on D1s. Well, before the D1s, I was playing on Panasonics.
Mm-hmm.
And I had a new mark mixer about this big with wood on the side, run by batteries.
This is DJ Flute representing Chilltown JC. When I was growing up, my favorite DJ from the hood was Wimpy B.
Why was Wimpy B your favorite DJ?
He was well known in the streets. He always did house parties and all that stuff. Didn't really get out too much back then, but always followed him and still see him doing his thing on SoundCloud, MixCloud. He's even got a couple YouTube videos up, and being a DJ myself, something that I got into at a young age, just been doing my thing, and I respect the people that actually paved that way for me as well.
Favorite DJ is going to be from Chilltown.
It was Stranger D. Also third.
Chilltown JC has been doing hip hop for years.
Nicky Bonds here in the house. I wish we was in Fulton Park, but that's where it started at. Right across the street from my warehouse. It was either Fulton Park or Rock Creek Park. That's which is Audubon Park. That's where it all went down at. Any park in Jersey City, if it had something to do with giving a party, they would donate food. The police, they'd donate security. But like I said, Fulton Park was the hit. And that's one of the only parks right now that the people didn't fix up. And I tried to get with that, but I have a new address out of state, so there's not too much I can say. But Fulton Park is what was happening. You can leave your kids out there with us. Everybody watched it, somebody's kids, while we played music.
Uh-huh.
And watched them dance and break dance and rapping and doing the twist and everything. But we had a real good time.
The most thing we had in our life was music.
So is it true that you used to build speakers? Can you break that down?
Yeah. Well, I went to school. And I had a good friend, was one of my boss, Rudy Pleasant. He taught me carpentry. He taught me, I'm being emotional right now. But listen, I have friends like Miss Evans and stuff right here with y'all. We in right now. Look, this is real. Like, this is deep. And these are my friends. These are my friends. And like I say, if my brother's intro, so am I. Like I said, I came here from the South, and I went to more funerals, and then I went to weddings. That shit is not funny. But music is my life. I gotta keep on dancing.
What's the song that you're most famous for playing in Fulton Park in Chilltown JC?
Listen to me. Oh, man, I listened to MSSB. Oh, Love is the Message. Made me kind of deep, made me famous. Like, so much with the people and my friends. And we had love, I'm telling you. I got a lot of friends, and they're good people, And I just played music. I gave away a lot of music, right, Flo? Ain't that right on?
Yes, sir.
I gave a lot of music away.
Yes, sir.
Had a lot of friends. And it was cool. Like somebody like my Aunt Jean, man, she looked out for me. Wow. And hanging out around here and in the community is cool. Because everybody looked out for me. And I looked out for everybody.
See from Montgomery Projects. I was down with the Four Fly Guys. I'd like to give a shout out, peace and blessings to upon Raheem. He was one of the Four Fly Guys, plus Mr. Rockwise. Well, we used to give shows at Outer Skates and Benmore, and it brought the hills downtown, Midtown, everybody together so we can just have fun. The four fly guys. It's not a Tarzan movie, so don't try to sue me. Don't swing on our jock. Dizzy Jane does a line. If you really like us, tell us, don't talk slick. But if you don't, baby, dig it.
I know what time it is, bars are right on schedule. Cypher, I'm live, but skip 2 steps ahead of you. The beat is peripheral, see you not typical. Perfect and physical, that's your true fit in the trivial. It's A all day, I'm a Mac with this mic shit. MC saw me and left, didn't come with the right shit. I spit the tight shit. Stay catching
and
slipping, never a flaw,
we
can see them shipping.
Oh, yeah, history, we helped create rap. Pioneers paved the way, some gave back. Some left the hood and never came back. But it's my hood, I rap Jersey to the death. Till time to get real now, don't get left. Fulton the white, the stagnant. Bidwell, babe, you the Wegman. What's the block that I hang in?
Great rappers out in Jersey.
I try being legit and humble, but these in this twisted jungle, just me and some clips and bundles. Got C, so I need to hustle. Be in the dark and starving, locked up like Martin Lawrence, shot up like Marvin Gaye. I'd rather spray to get my honor. No longer in adolescence, I'm out in these streets and stressing. Not over money, just dummies who need police protection. They wanna lock and slam us. Elders, they can't stand us. Cops got cool with grandma, taught her to watch us with cameras. Youngers got no manners, like curses, they only grandma. They gotta hustle, cause at Christmas they play their own Santa. Hard not to go bananas, harder to hold these hammers. Instead of busting and burning niggas like JoJo Dancer. Damn, your life is calling, hustling, feel like I'm falling. I plan to get endorsed by Spalding for heavily balling. If I can stay away from snakes and all their recordings. Feds, Jakes, and rats wanna see me in coffins. It's all on my team now, can't shorten my green how. Got too much in the making, I'm caking in the meanwhile. I'm a mean child, usually where the fiends found. Or teaching the seeds how to lead without the street route.
Early days of hip-hop and when all this stuff began, there was a big movement coming out of New Jersey. You know, especially Chilltown.
What's your name?
My name is Prince Kyrie from the group Positively Black.
When you started, you know, explain to the audience what you do, what you did, and what year you started, and how you formulated and found your group.
First, we started off in the year 1988. Me, King Not G, DJ Storm, DJ Tyrell, we started the group, and rest in peace, my brother Salon. We felt that we wanted to make a difference in hip-hop as far as the conscious mind state and what brothers was doing in the game. And we wanted to come out with a style of straight truth with no chaser. And I felt that's what we did. My brother, Najee, came up with the name. He was instrumental in doing a lot of the core planning. Because, you know, a lot of people thought because they was younger, brothers didn't do what they needed to do. But 88 was the year, and we was also managed by my sister, Eve Champagne, one of the first female managers, as well as female rappers, Jersey City and things like that. Shout out to you. And we basically just try to set a new precedence in hip-hop, and Jersey City had nothing like us, you know what I'm saying? And with all due respect to all the pioneers, we just came with a perspective of raising black consciousness. And with that, the youth made a difference in that attitude. So when you look at today's youth, you can see that their consciousness is not there. You know what I'm saying? So with Positively Black, that it was a mind state, it was a movement, and we just tried to keep to that over standard.
So was you ever signed to any labels or anything like that?
Our first label was Trumpet, which was my family, Pete Kaiser, Paul Kaiser. He also was instrumental in starting the group. His father ran Trumpet Records, and from Trumpet, we were signed to Select, which was Weir and Warner Electric Atlantic. We were down with Chubb Rock, Kid and Play, a bunch of the heavyweights at the time, and UTFO. And it's funny because I remember being signed, and we were in the boardroom around with the big heavyweights, so to speak, at the time, and Kango from UTFO and them was kind of giving us the new look of, oh, so you the new Jax, you know what I'm saying? And hip-hop, that competitive effort was always there. It didn't matter if you was on some positive shit or whatever. Cats was coming, you know, they felt you was coming for their job. And this is what hip-hop is. It's a competitive sport, and I think most don't realize that. I don't care what you're talking about, how conscious, positive, or whatever, it's competitive. And everybody's trying to gun for that number one spot. The crown is heavy. And a lot of brothers don't realize that, and sisters, you know, you're a pioneer, this and you know, but what we did was we said, fuck it, we gonna be us. And even with Jersey City, a lot of cats wasn't really trying to feel the vibe of being positive or doing right. But as you can see today, shit is fucked up. They should have really took heed. So at this point, you know, Positively Black still alive.
One of the first artists that they had was Chill Rob G.
One of my favorite MCs in Chilltown that got a deal back in the days was Chill Rob G. And before Chill Rob G got his deal, there's a lot of crews and a lot of DJs who wouldn't allow Chill Rob to grab the mic and do his thing. But for some reason, I took to him, and I always gave him the mic. I always, hey, go ahead, do you. And to this day, I'm glad I did.
I am the truth. Talent is never temporary. I am the proof and a plague on my adversary. Test me at your peril. I keeps a razor sterile. Beware of the chill one. The technique is thorough. I feel about the question?
Yeah, the people constantly.
I feel like it's a sickening question.
Okay?
I answer that question 50 times a day. So how would you feel about it if you had to answer a question 50 times a day? Same question.
So what did happen?
Here's today's 30th answer. I got 20 to go. This from the Snap sampled a song that I did called Let the Words Flow. And they sampled some other elements and put together a song called I Got the Power. And they started, plagiarizing it, performing it. You got Turbo B running around the country, acting like, you know, he's the originator, knowing that, you know, he stole that. And he's just a puppet being used by Arista Records. And, you know, by now, really, man, if you don't know what happened, you know, come on, you should know what happened. If you really care, if you don't care, then why you?
Well, as many fans was not getting the truth, and they figured, the court, they say, if you want the truth, go to the horse.
I'm just saying, I've answered.
Yeah, but some people not checking that footage out,
and they told me.
In Chilltown,
so
they wanted
again,
to know.
Mm-hmm. Once again, Turbo B is a dude from the group Snap. He's their lead rapper, and they going around doing their version of my song, and Arista Records is pumping it out while I'm on Wild Pitch Records, which was a small indie label at the time, and you know they won. Yeah? Arista had a lot of money, man. And Wild Pitch couldn't compete with that, so, you know, that's how that all broke down. Discussing it, I'm fine with it. I've come to peace with it a long time ago. Because the thing is, I continue to create. If that was the only thing I could do, like if that was my last lyrics, I would have been hurt and devastated. I might have died. I might have folded up and died. But, you know, I wrote another round the next day. I wrote another song that, while I was listening, I was probably, you know, creating lyrics at that point. You know what I mean? So it's not really that serious. From that standpoint.
Speaking of lyrics, can you give us the song, I Got the Power, in lyrics form?
I'll give you the original. The original is, I'm dope, face it, shoot it, freebase it, pour it in a glass, drink it, chase it, then chill, plex, feel the fully fret. The impact is similar to a train wreck. It's whack to me when the beat is more hype than the MC, because what he's saying is empty, dull, void, without substance or content. You need to slow your speed, stop the nonsense. These are the words of the rising sun, surprising some who thought I was just another humdrum. Average type, not MC, found the mic and thought he was hype. Nah, that's not me. I'll take a page, write a phrase to rephrase it, treat it like a national flag, and upraise it so a nation of people can feel proud about a brother who speaks out real loud. I'm here to rock the show, clock the dough, and let the words flow. And they sampled different parts of that verse and created I Got the Power. Thank you, guys.
I got the power!
Mad love and respect, yo, wherever I go. But I still don't feel like I'm untouchable, so my face there, ice grill in my suit. I keep the heat that could blast all the black off your ass if you ain't feeling me. Gangsta click, hardcore gangsta chick, cook a mean plate of pasta and vodka sauce, extra thick. And San Vito sipping red wine, feeling needle. Brothers think they coming harder, don't bother, cause I'm the godfather.
Y'all been doing this whether or not, like me or not, think that I'm a cop.
Before I was a kid, around the time I was a tot. Before John Gotti bought a Glock, I ran a trunk, learned how to shop, and Timmy McVeigh blew up the spot. Way before Peter Barnes sold a bag on the block, around the time blacks was in Africa and didn't share crop. Before the first 187 on a cop, before Dick met the whole Jane and got the mud call spot. Before Michael Jackson grabbed his crotch, before girls took brothers to call for money that brothers ain't got, I was hot as a bomb, baby, like, ah, how to sound, ah. Before Digital Underground met Tupac, you want me to stop? I think not. You starting to believe that I used to rock before Kurt met Spock. Now this wild style I got patented. I walk around with a laminate saying I'm lyrically smashing.
Well, when I started, I was more solo than I picked up that with a crew. We called ourselves Unique Three. It was me, myself, Brooklyn D. It was another Brooklyn D, besides the cheaper crew, Brooklyn D. And Lenny Lynn, King Lenny Lynn, Z-Rock D, Big Muff, Mike. And we, you know, put a little crew together. And Crush Love, and a couple of other cats that was down with us, but the main music part of Unique 3 was those members. And we got together and we started writing and trying to, you know, do shows and stuff like that. Then later on we picked up, later on we became Unique Nation, where Unique Nation consists of different crews, like Bubble Fuck Posse, that's the posse from the woods. We had a couple of members, our Puerto Rican clique, South American clique. We had different cliques from around the way, Boswick clique, because that's where I ran from, Boswick. But mostly I was in Kerry Woods, and that was home to me, even though I was a hill man, but Kerry Woods was my home. All my homies was there. Big Donnie D, you know, Mello, another Mello, you know. He used to sing, Cool J from back in the day, he was dope. But Donnie D was real dope. He passed on, God bless the dead. He had passed on. And back then, we had Shaqui, he from the woods. And boy, he was fast. And we had a club, me and this guy named Brian up on Jackson, a Boswick, called A Place to Be. And we used to party and battle a lot of people. And you know, come to think about it, in fact, we battled Sweet Slick and Sly, Albion, and I forgot the other one. I know, I think Victor Quick was DJing for him. And it was me, King, Lenny Lynn. And our DJ at the time was Shaqui. You know, they was there first. We let them go ahead in there first. And we came in behind. It was about maybe 500-600 people in there. It's unbelievable that that many people fit in that little place, but it was packed. We, you know, came through the crowd because we spray painted our name on the wall, Unique Nation. And it lit up. Wish I had a camera back then. But lit up, we put the black light on it. Then we had the DJ booth up in the air. We built a little stage and stuff. And we got up there, you know, tore Albie ass up, you know. And we did our work, you know. At the end of the party, I think Jimmy Mack was there. Maybe, I don't know, a stranger was there. They was cool people with me. In fact, Stranger was real cool people. In fact, he get Swift, which became my DJ also, to do parties at number 11 school with him and stuff like that. Smell of death, flesh burning in the day dawning, continue on until the morning. Lucifer, you ain't got no business here. When it's time for me to go, well, I will understand the pain I bear. Close to me, hell ain't no stranger. From the cradle, mama tried, but I couldn't blame her. But in 1969, mama wants to commit suicide. When I heard her cry, I died 1,000 times. Close to death,
befriended me as a child. Mind fucked up, I walked my last mile. But then on, I knew I had to face danger. Do my time in a concrete container. It's a fool's eyes. I'm doing wrong, won't live long. I won't be strong. That's a dupe of mine. Be full gone, marching down death row. Listening to the 23rd song, the warrior. Protect my set, type killer. Survive the best way, I know my drug dealer. Family tree star, I'm a bastard. Down to jail, just some business heads and others.
Sir Brown was practicing for the battle. He's, you know, getting his rhymes together, choosing his beats, all that he's gonna do. And he had a secret weapon, me, my sister, and my cousin. So who knew I was arranging back then, but I arranged like this cool little doo-wop section do, like with ooh wah oohs while he's rapping. It's like ooh wah ooh, ooh wah ooh, wah ooh. And it was harmony. I gave different notes to my sister and my cousin. And I taught him a singing part, and then he wrote more to it. So he sang and rapped. It was so dope. It was incredible. Actually, Bismarcky has a copy of it. I'm trying to get a copy from him. So the battle took place at PS number 11 in Chilltown, JC. I'll never forget. I was so excited. It was like the first time on stage supporting Sir Brown. And it was, everybody was like, it was fun. And he ripped it. Love you, you know, all the other participants.
Spirituality, respect.
Uh-huh.
You know, fuck religion.
Uh-huh.
People need to get on a mind state of respect your circle and respect your space, and others respect your space.
Uh-huh.
Then we can take care of our business. Then we can do hip-hop, play sports, all the things you want, and even down to those that's going to do their drug selling. That's some things you can't stop. But if you could organize your shit and make a negative a positive, then we can make this thing work, everything. So even with the hip-hop world, you know, you got the youngsters out here doing their thing, the Joe Buttons and all these other cats. They don't pay homage to the old school. And at the end of the day, if you don't know your past, you don't know your future. Just like I got this chemist shit on, this is Egyptian. This me knowing my past. You feel what I'm saying? This is me knowing where I come from, my royal roots. So again, if we know Chilltown had all his lessons, Sweet Slick and Sly, I mean, and to give the brother Albie Al a shout out, he's one of the main reasons I started rapping. I'm on the bus stop, I hear this chick talking, yo, Albie Al. I'm like, who the fuck's Albie Al? You know what I'm saying? This prince looking Italian, little half black nigga. I'm like, oh shit, this nigga got juice. And that was inspirational. So that dude was a legend, and respect to him and the whole Sweet Slick and Sly movement, because that was legendary. They had brothers from New York respecting them. They had brothers from South Jersey, out of state respecting the movement of Jersey City. After that movement died, Jersey City died. That's 100. So we need to get back to the essence. The writing is on the wall like Egyptian hieroglyphics. We need to respect our past, respect now, and we'll respect the future. Jersey City is a gold mine. But we end up fighting ourselves and turn the gold into fool's gold, pyrite. So you all in this together. And until y'all come together, Jersey City's not gonna have that respect, because even with making this documentary, you see the problems you had in
Jersey City is where I'm from. 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 Jersey City is where I'm from.
Don't ever try to stick me.
H.I.P. H.O.P. consists of the double B, bars and beats, lyrical skills from the English.
Now, why do you think they don't take Chilltown serious in the music industry?
They don't take Chilltown that serious in the music industry because, you know,
it's not really promoted like that. You know what I mean? There's none of the artists out there from Chilltown that's really, you know, blowing Jersey City up like that. When we was doing it, you know, we was saying it. We was saying where we was from. So, you know, you don't really have nobody out there. You got Joe Buttons, you know what I mean? He's out there, but he, you know, he ain't out there propping Jersey City like that. I'm pretty sure it's a lot of talent out here that ain't been discovered yet. You know, you got some little kid, some little female right now sitting at the table. She ain't doing nothing but writing the hotness. You know what I mean? Hot bars for infinity, but we haven't heard it yet.
A lot of rappers from New York, they used to, you know, hang out right in Jersey City with us, with me. You know, with Kool Sub Brown, with Chuck Luck, with Sweet Lick and Slide, with Joey Tom from Duncan Projects. You know, even Dougie Fresh, the first time he ever heard himself on the radio, he was in the car with me and Chuck Luck and a girl named Jennifer Jones. You know, the Cold Crush Four, my man JDL. You know, they used to damn near live in Jersey City. Like,
what you contribute to Chilltown Hip Hop?
Chilltown Hip Hop?
Yes.
Question put to me was, what did I do for Chilltown Hip Hop? I worked at D&D Studios for a few years. And made a few records. It hasn't been a time that I haven't made a record and said Jersey City name. So Flex, what's up? MOP, what's up? Y'all know all the real hip hop guys. Y'all know what's up. Jersey City always been here. Always gonna be here.
Who's some of your influence out of Chilltown, JC?
My influences definitely was Albie Al, Jimmy Mack, Friendship Bass, and Big Stranger D, Sweet Slick and Sly. Absolutely, without them, I probably wouldn't even be in hip hop.
Party people say the walk is a lucky charm. I go off on the mic like a fire alarm. When I'm on the streets, I'm very calm. And now I'm holding the mic in a hand of my palm. House and things like a farmer on a farm. Anyone can rock the mic, you only need one arm. But it's the mind that generates the waves and action. Whoa. The magnetic center attraction, like bird. This, like that thing. I need you with a crystal instead.
The state of Chilltown hip hop. What do you think happened in Chilltown? Why you don't think we get recognition in Chilltown?
I don't think we stick together as far as artists are concerned in Chilltown. I think everybody's divided and everybody wants to do what they want to do. And I think it's always been a set formula for when you're dealing with the industry. I think you have to stay honest and true to your team and yourself, and then everybody else will respect you for that.
What can they do to make it better?
I think encourage and assist each other in the endeavor that we all share, which is to become a recording star or what have you, a writer or a publisher or a videographer or whatever. I think we all just have to stick together, make our force be known and recognized with, and I think that's when the industry will start respecting us a little bit more.
Okay, so when you first heard about hip-hop in Chilltown?
The first time I heard about hip-hop in Chilltown was probably, the first time I ever heard about hip-hop, period, was with Chabon the God, Anthony Spann. He took me to Brooklyn, and that's when I first heard hip-hop. And I was in the basement, so I heard that. Look at Bo Peep right there. Real hip-hop right there, Bo Peep, my man. Where you going, Bo? All right. It's champagne. So I think the first time in Jersey City I heard hip hop was Stranger D. I heard Stranger mixing records in Armstrong Park, and that's when I was like, what is that? And I heard him cutting the break beats and all that, and then I started hearing like underground tapes back then of Busy B, of Kumo D.
You told me no commitments and you best it too. Oh baby, I'm not gonna be able to do. Have you do it? I'm not gonna be able to do. Have you do it? I'm not gonna be able to do. Have you do it? I'm not gonna be able to do. Have you do it? I'm not gonna be able to do. Have you do it? I'm not gonna be able to do. Have you do it? I'm not gonna be able to do. Have you do it? I'm not gonna be able to do.
I belong to the Double X Posse. We started dealing with music in 1984.
and we found some of the best urban rappers. I put my money up and we took it to the top. That's what we did. From really NBC Warehouse, we was an offspring from that. Then it came Sweet Slick and Slide. From there, then it was Little NBC. Then I branched off from them on my boy Abby Al died, God bless the dead. We started the Double X Posse. I got that name from Stranger D because he said everything I did was unknown. So we used it and we ran with it and it took off. Mm-hmm. We was known for like shutting down parties because at that time, Abby Al was the man. Like we go to New York, we go to Bronx, we go anywhere and he will really like take over a party. And that's how everything really started. Like we was on his coattail. That was the man back then and that. He knew everybody, he knew where to go, he knew how to rock a party, and he put songs together.
And some of the groups that came over to Chilltown that you recall from New York at that time in the 80s?
Dougie Fresh, Biz Markie, Phyllis Four. Oh man, the list go on, man. There's so many groups that we dealt with back then. It was crazy. We even went on tour with them, man. Tours back then was like you had to get a van and you go over the states. We didn't have airplanes and jets. But we made it everywhere we had to go, and that's why, you know, our names stick out the way it stick out, because we did hard work. We worked hard for what we wanted. Warm Daddy was a guy that never wrote anything down. Whoa. Everything he ever did was from off the top of the head. I mean, straight songs, straight off the top of the head. Jimmy Mack, he was like a hype man. He was a guy that can make hooks. And when I'm telling you he make a hook and he drives the crowds crazy, that's what he did. Sugar Ray, he was a lyricist. He knew what it took to make something pop.
I think the first thing I ever done professionally was when Biz Markie and my brother, Sir Brown, became friends. And Biz Markie would always come to the house and Dougie Fresh. And Biz heard me singing. So he asked me, so he asked my brother if I could come and sing on a record. And that record became I'm Sugar Free, Granddaddy IU. So I did that, I did the video. So that was my first musical professional gig. And then of course I had to mature a little bit and then I got back into the industry and I wrote, then I began writing because I just took to it. I loved it. Vincent Herbert actually, who's Tamar's husband and Lady Gaga's manager, he and I became friends through meeting him through Teddy Riley and Bernard Bell, who actually put me in the music industry. When I met Vincent Herbert, just being in the industry, he saw me in a studio giving suggestions for writing, even though I was there doing everybody's background vocals, vocal arranging, vocal producing. So he called me one day and asked me to come to the studio to write a song for this new group, which was Beyonce's group, Kelly's group, Destiny's Child. And I told him no. I was like, I'm not a writer. Get somebody else to write in. I'll come in and vocal produce them. I'll do their backgrounds, their arrangements. And Vincent, who is such a great business person, lied at the time. I was like, I already told the label you're coming. It's booked for 12 noon. I was like, oh my God, so I gotta do this. So the next day I go, write the song. I was so nervous. Now back then there were little digital recorders we would use, little teeny micro cassette tapes. I don't know if y'all know about that, but I bought one of those from the store. And when I got to the studio, I asked Vincent, the producer, the engineer, everyone, to just leave for like an hour or two and leave the music repeating. So I wrote whatever I wrote. I actually co-wrote some of it with one of the producers, Calvin. He gave me a part. And then I asked everyone to just leave. And I wrote on the little micro recorder when I was done on a little beige piece of tape, press play. And I put it on the recorder, sat it on the console, and I bounced. And I called Vincent and I was like, I'm done. He was like, I'm on my way back. I'm like, I left. He was like, why'd you leave? I was that nervous because it was new for me. But that's the thing about trying new things. That's what courage is. Courage is moving forward even when you're scared and you never know what's behind that door. I was scared, but I said, I'm gonna try it. All these people were looking at me and I did it. When he got back, press play, he loved it. They called, was like, come back here. So I came back. I was only at the restaurant down the street, myself and a good friend named Mia, actually who I had lunch with today. So when I got back to the studio, all the execs were hugging me. Oh my God, this is amazing, you know. And 2 days later, Beyonce and all of them came and we did the song and it was No, 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 their first number one hit that gave them their start. and now they have a star on Hollywood Walk of Fame. So I feel blessed to be a part of the legend of Destiny's Child, and I may be working with Beyonce again on this CD. Actually, her last CD, they reached out to me and I was not in the country. So I'm gonna be reaching out to them and get together again.
So who else you wrote for?
Oh, I wrote for Jaheim. I don't know if you know Put That Woman First. That's another single. I co-wrote that with a dope writer named Balewa. He used to be in this group called The Clutch. Balewa and I wrote Put That Woman First for Jaheim. We also wrote Fabulous for Jaheim with the children, Never G-I-V-E-U-P. After doing all those songs and realizing writers have a voice, I wanted to make a difference.
They call it the motherland because we losing brothers. We in the ghetto now, might as well call it the gutter. They give us guns, now we killing each other. Picture streets, dog, where everyone humble and nobody run.
Now, tell us about any battles you probably had back in the days as a DJ and some of your story.
Some of the battles that I had in Jersey City were pretty much legendary. I battled pretty much every major DJ in Jersey City at the time. Not all, but most. The most significant DJ battle that I was in was at Outer Skates. And that was actually a DJ convention hosted by Rosie B, the legendary Rosie B. And with that battle, it had to be at least about 10 DJs in that battle. And to make a long story short, I won that battle with all the DJs. I think Stranger was in it, Stranger D from Sweet Slick and Sly, and others who I can't remember off the top, but I think what set that battle apart was because when I came out with blindfolds, handcuffs, with a cape, and I came out and I was rocking three turntables in the beatbox simultaneously, and was cut with my elbows, my chin, everything, and that really, really rocked the crowd, and I won first place.
Now, how about some New York cats that you can name that was in Chill Town in the late 70s and early 80s that, you know, is in the mainstream music industry now that was in Chill Town? Can you name a few and elaborate on that a little bit?
Of course, you had Grandmaster Flash and the Furious Five. They were here all the time. They were here at Benmore Roller Rink. That was on Communipaw Avenue, which is a spot that we used to party at all the time. Outer Skates, that was a roller rink also, but we did do parties there a lot. They was there. You had the Force MCs, or the Force MDs with Stevie D, Mercury, DJ Dr. Rock, over there all the time. You had the Cold Crush Bros with JDL. You know, they was here all the time. Dougie Fresh, Bismarcky. I mean, the list goes on. They were here. This was their second home away from
home. Jersey was six boroughs.
It seems like Jersey City was like a brother to Staten Island.
JC, hip hop legend, all the stories untold as the story unfolds. Or the Chill Town, JC.
I just want to touch on some DJs that I must give shout outs to. DJ Flo, you know, my brother, DJ Nicky B, DJ Thurm, DJ Wimpy B, DJ Stranger, DJ Count Basil. Those was one of the two biggest battles that we ever had in Jersey City, Nicky Barnes and Count Basil at Lincoln High School. I mean, the turnout was like crazy. It was like one of them New York clubs that you couldn't move but just sweat in there. You know, like, it's many more DJs. DJ Victor Quick, you know, that's one dude that we started with too from on the float. Float was like his mentor, you know what I'm saying, beside my brother. So DJ Bryant, you know, DJ Ola, you know, there's a couple of DJs that, I mean, like, they can go to a party and they can come on with stacks. You know what I'm saying? Now the turn has turned, the tide has turned, because the DJs are now are the same DJs from the ones that was there, like our sons. My brother have a son, his name is DJ K. I mean, he turns a party out ridiculous. My son, DJ Wildcat, on the radio stations doing his numbers. I mean, like, these guys, they didn't get it from nowhere else. It came from the tree. It's inside of them. to do these things, because music is like, it runs in my family. Like, everybody have that touch for this music, and they make it work. You know what I'm saying? I just pray to God that some of these guys that's rapping can really see that you're not gonna get to the mountaintop without a team.
Nicky Barr set a trend for me. DJ Basil set me a trend. Thermy Thurm set me a trend. Grand Wizard Capone. There's a lot of DJs I can mention, but I know I mentioned those particular DJs because I remember them for doing something for me in the game. They didn't hands-on do it for me as teaching me, but something I took from each one of those DJs that gave me, you know, the stamina of who I am and how I allowed me to lay the foundation.
Mm-hmm. Okay, so why you think people in the music industry does not respect Chilltown JC, or do you think they respect Chilltown JC?
They respect us to a certain level, but when it comes to looking for talent, they don't come over here looking for us. They have to go over there and get the talent. But they don't really come at us for DJs. They don't come at us for MCs. So they've always been hard on us. So because of that, we always had to be on top of our A game all the time. So because we're on our A game all the time, we always reign supreme in our game. Always. Chilltown like that, always.
Do you think that some of the people in Chilltown who receive deals play a factor in that?
I don't think they play a factor. I think they got a deal because they earned it. There's no reason to say, oh, they got a deal and they pushed everybody off to the wayside. That didn't happen. People got deals because they got deals. They earned it. You know, like, you know, Double X Posse, Chill Rob G, you know, Double J, these gentlemen got their deals because they earned it. It wasn't the fact that they got the deals and pushed people off to the side. No, that didn't happen. They earned it. So because they earned it, they stayed grounded. They still stayed in the hood with us. So I don't see where, you know, people would even look at it another way.
Do you know the first female DJ name in Jersey City?
First female DJ? I really couldn't tell you, but I say it's my sister, Bunny B.
Okay, DJ?
Bunny B. All right, she did my parties with me back in the early 80s. She did the first party she did with me was at the Bergen School, April 11th, 1981. My sister, Bunny B. I got clips on her when she DJed at my birthday party with MC Key the Key on the mic, and she represented.
Go ahead.
Shot King rapping Chilltown. People listening. Watch me shine while I'm glistening. Yeah, I'm tough from a diamond in the rough. Came to scorch once you just fell off the porch. Yeah, you brought this ass whipping cause you caught with your hand in the jar. I know who you are, never saw your ass on the Ava, even at the Arc Bar. Before your time, after leave the road to pine. Out of every group, you had one real rap. Treacherous 3 had Mo D. Cold Crush had Grandmaster Caz. Jersey City, we had the Killer Force. They had Danger D, but they had a real lyricist that was phenomenal. His name is Cool Sir Brown, all right? And I pay homage to him, total homage. Cool, I love you, you know what I mean? I love you. You made me know how to write and lyrics and what a lyricist was supposed to do.
Looking at Chilltown from a pioneering perspective, you gotta kinda like put them in line with that, first of all, because they're so connected to New York in the first place. They kinda like go hand in hand, New York and Chilltown. Whether cats want to acknowledge it or admit it or even be aware of it or not. Just from that reason alone. And then for me personally, me having that bond and connection and having my finger on the pulse of what Jersey City represented, for me personally, of course they're pioneers. They laid the groundwork. And lastly, you can mention that they were there at that time. You got a lot of people that claim pioneership just by default because you're there. You know, you got a lot of people like, you got a cat that was at a show with me in 82 and he considers himself a pioneer because he came to the party. No. I mean, if you're putting in the time, the energy, the effort, and the work, the body of work that's come out of Jersey City, that's come out of Chilltown, like, you know, like again, the lineage of people that we mentioned, that speaks for itself, that whether or not they are their pioneers, their mainstays, and of course they don't get the just desserts that they deserve.
And why you don't think they get the justice they deserve?
Again, I'll mention the reason that I think that they don't get their props the way they should, because hip-hop as a whole, and I don't want to get on this milk crate, but hip-hop as a whole is in such discombobulation. The misconception of what hip-hop is, you start there, like, you know, what you see in the mainstream and what you see on TV, for the most part, what you hear on the radio, that ain't even hip hop. But to go even more in depth than that, like, there's a disconnect from the hip hop, or what's perceived as hip hop, from a New York City perspective, let alone Jersey City. So if New York is perceived as outside of the hip hop box, Jersey City falls by the wayside by association with that. So yeah, you know, I just find that to be a little bit, you know, disconcerting, but you know, I'm not surprised.
No matter what your placement, we gon' grind and make a wave, we good. Living no worries and no complaint, we good. They came in cash, but showing no pain, when we good. Just doing our thing, ripping our fam, still riding with our heat and our faith, wherever we land, we good. Living no worries and no complaint, we good.
Yeah.
They came in cash, but showing no pain. Just doing our thing, ripping our face, still riding with our heat and our
faith,
whatever
we do. Yeah, I'm God with an extra O. Yeah, the flow extra cold. Yeah, it's like 10 below. Freezer section rope. Iceberg, you froze like a vegetable. Ice cubes on the Metrodome. Yeah. We ain't worried about the bullshit. You not a kingpin, you just a gutter ball. Talking about you really ball, nigga, not at all. I spit seasons, winter, spring, summer, fall. Right, that's where the smoke, DZA. We don't play unless the engine is pressing play. I'm passionate about what I say, cause I live this shit like every day. All right, okay.
We good, living no worries and no complaint. We good, they came in cash but showing no pain. We good, just doing our thing, ripping our fam, still riding with our heat and our faith, wherever we land. We good, living no worries and no complaint. We good, they came in cash but showing no pain.